dear students, now I am discussed about equipotential surface. Equipotential surface. What is an equipotential surface? The surface at which constant value of potential at all points is called equipotential surface. Surface at which constant value of potential, constant value of potential at all points is called equipotential surface. Equipotential surface. Example for equipotential surface. Example for equipotential surface. The charged conductor of any shape and size is an equipotential surface. Charged conductors. Conductor of any shape and size. Any shape and size is an equipotential surface. Equipotential surface. Important point regarding the equipotential surface. The potential difference between any two points on the equipotential surface is zero. Why it is zero? Because there is no work done to move the charge from one point to another point in an equipotential surface. Because of potential difference between any two point on the equipotential surface is zero. Next, we discussed about graphical or diagrammical representation of equipotential surface. Diagrammical representation. A diagram for equipotential surface. First diagram. Equipotential surface due to point charge. Equipotential surface due to point charge. Isolated positive charge. How you draw isolated positive charge? Like this. This is the positive charge. The electric field lines due to equipotential surface is electric field is always normal to the equipotential surface. Like this. The field lines are radially outward. Electric field lines, these concentric lines or concentric circles represents an equipotential surface due to positive charge. These concentric circles represents equipotential surface due to positive charge. Similarly, the equipotential surface for equipotential surface due to system of two positive charges. Equipotential surface due to system of two positive charges. System of two positive charges. Like this. This is one positive charge. This is another positive charge. These are the equipotential surfaces. These concentric lines represents an equipotential surface. These concentric lines are represents equipotential surface. Where equipotential surface is very closer to the region of strong electric field, like this. Equipotential surface is very closer to the region of strong electric field, and it is further to the region of weak electric field. This diagram represents equipotential surface due to system of two positive charges. Similarly, next, equipotential surface due to dipole. How you draw diagram for equipotential surface due to dipoles? Equipotential surface due to dipole. How you draw diagrams? This is the positive charge. This is the negative charge. Two unlike charges are separated by a very small distance. The field lines are short from positive charge and towards the negative charge. The field lines due to negative charge is radially inwards. Field lines due to positive charge is radially outwards. These concentric circles represents equipotential surface due to dipole. Equipotential surface due to dipoles. Dipole means two unlike charges separated by a very small distance. Next, equipotential surface due to uniform electric field. Potential surface due to uniform electric field. Uniform electric field means the electric field is same value at all points between the two parallel plate conductors. The charge distributions due to electric field due to charge distribution same for all points. It's called uniform electric field. The equipotential surface due to uniform electric field diagram is like this. This is the diagrammical representation. Diagrammical representation of equipotential surface due to uniform electric field between the charge plate of the conductors. Next, properties of equipotential surface. Equipotential surface. First one is two equipotential surfaces never intersect. Intersect because of from the point of intersection having two potential. It's impossible for there will be a two potential in the point of intersections. It's not possible because of two equipotential surfaces or never intersect. There will be a two potential at the point of intersection, if not possible. That's why two equipotential surfaces or never intersect. Next, the electric field is always normal to the surface of the conductor, normal to the equipotential surface. Our electric field is always perpendicular to the surface of the charged conductor. Surface of the charged conductor is nothing but an equipotential surface. The electric field is always normal or perpendicular distance from the surface of the charged conductors. Next point of properties. The potential difference between any two points on the equipotential surface is zero. Potential difference between any two points on the equipotential surface is zero. Because of there is no work done to move the charge from one point to another point. Because there is no work done to move the charge from one point to another point in an equipotential surface. There is no work done to move the charge from one point to another point in an equipotential surface. The work done zero, the potential difference between any two points on the equipotential surface is also zero. Next properties. Equipotential surfaces are used to indicate the reason of strong and electric field. Equipotential surface indicates reason of strong and weak electric field. Next, equipotential surface is closer to the region of strong electric field. It is further to the region of weak electric field. Equipotential surface is very closer to the region of strong electric field. The strong electric field region, equipotential surface is very close to that region. It is further or it is far away from the region of weak electric field. Equipotential surface is far. Further means far away from the region of weak electric field. These are the important properties of equipotential surface. How you write the properties? First properties. Two equipotential surfaces are never intersect because of there will be a point of intersection having two potentials. Not possible to draw the two potential in the point of intersections. Next, equipotential surface, electric field is always normal or perpendicular to the equipotential surface. Next point, equipotential surface indicates region of strong and weak electric field. How you indicates the electric field? The equipotential surface is very closer to the region of strong electric field, and equipotential surface is further away from the region of weak electric field. These are the important properties of equipotential surface. Why the potential difference between any two points on the equipotential surface is zero? Because of there is no work done to move the charge from one point to another point in the equipotential surfaces. Next, there is the expression for relation between potential, electrostatic potential and fields. Very important derivation. Derive the expression for relation between electric field and electric potential. Electric field and potential. Expression for relation between electric field and electric potential. How you derive? By considering two equipotential surfaces. One equipotential surface A, another equipotential surface B. Draw the electric field due to equipotential surface in perpendicular distance. Electric field is always normal to the perpendicular distance. The potential of A is V. Potential of B is V minus dV. Minus dV indicates the potential of the surface decreases with increasing electric field directions. Consider point P be the point on the equipotential surface B. Distance R from the distance B R from the equipotential surface A. How you calculate the relation between A and V? First, you take amount of work done to bringing a unit positive charge from P to O against the electric field is given by amount of work done to bringing the unit positive charge, amount of work done to bringing unit positive charge. From P to O at distance dr against the electric field. Against the electric field is given by dW is equal to minus E into dr or minus E dr cos theta because of work done per unit positive charge is called electric field. Electric field is equal to force per unit charge. Unit charge means 1 coulomb of charge. In the case of 1 coulomb of charge, electric field must be equal to electrostatic force. That's why we use equations dW must be equal to minus E into dr or E dr cos of 180 degree work done. Means work must be done against the electrostatic field due to source charge. Where we take equation 1. In this case, work done must be equal to potential difference between two points. In this case, work done must be equal to potential difference between two equipotential surfaces. Work done must be equals to PV between A and B is given by dW is equal to V minus of V minus dV. V minus of V minus dV, where dW is equal to V minus V minus into minus plus, it is dV. Cancel. Work done must be equals to potential difference between any two points on the equipotential surface. Put this dW value in equation 1, you get dV is equal to minus E into dR, or E is equal to minus dV by dR. This is the relation between electric field and electric potentials. Now you derive this by using two equipotential surfaces A and B of potential V and V minus dV. Consider point P on the equipotential surface B from distance dR from the O on the equipotential surface A. The work done to bringing a unit positive charge from P to O against the electric field is given by dW is equal to minus C into dR. The work done in this case, work done must be equal to potential difference between two points of the equipotential surface is given by dW is equal to V minus of V minus dV. Minus dV indicates the decrease in potential with increase in electric field. This negative sign indicates the potential is goes on decreases with increase in distance along the direction of electric field. The potential is becoming goes on decreases. That's why we use negative signs. Another alternate method for derivations. Alternate method. How we use alternate method for these derivations? By considering point charge Q is placed at a point O. Consider point O and positive charge placed, source charge is placed at point O. It produces electric field along these directions. It produces electric field along these directions. Consider two points within the electric field. Those two points are A and B at distance dr. The unit positive charge Q naught is moved from A to B is called potential difference. What is a potential difference? The work done to bringing a unit positive charge from or move the unit positive charge from one point to another point within the electric field is called potential difference. Okay, definition of potential difference. Definition of potential difference. Difference dV is equal to amount of work done, the small amount of work done to move the unit positive charge from A to B. Small amount of work done to move unit positive charge. Unit positive charge from A to B at distance dr against the electric field. Due to plus Q charge, andre source charge given by dV is equal to work done by quantity of charge transfer from one point to another point is equal to dW by Q naught. Q naught is the unit positive charge is moved from A to B against the electric field. A to B against the electric field. You take equation 1. According to definition of work done is equal to the external force into displacement, where dV is equal to minus f into dr by q naught because of dw is equal to f dr, force into displacement, the small displacement, amount of work done to move the charge frame, here to be with a small displacement dr, negative sign indicates against the electric field. In this equation dw, where f, this is equation 2, where force by unit positive charge is called electric field at that point. Force by unit positive charge is the electric field. Substitute or put E value into, get relation between potential and field. Where F by Q naught is electric field, force per unit positive charge, or unit positive charge would experience a force, is called electric field at that point. Force by charge is equal to field into dr, where this is the relation for alternate method for dv by dr. This is the alternate method for, there is the expression for relation between electrostatic potential and electric field is equal to E is equal to minus dv by dr. Negative sign indicates the potential is goes on decreases with respect to distance. Negative sign indicates the potential is goes on decreases with respect to distance along the direction of electric field. It is also nothing but relation between electric field and electric potential is E is equal to minus dv by dr. Next, the potential energy of system of two charges in the absence of external electric field. Next concept, potential energy of system of two charges. Potential energy of system of two charges. Potential energy of system of two charges consider. What is potential energy? Amount of work done to, amount of work done to bringing a charge Q amount of work done to bringing charge Q from amount of work done to bringing charge Q from infinity to given position, infinity to given position is called potential energy, is called potential energy. Work done to bringing a charge Q from infinity to in the given position of the another charge, it possesses potential energy. How you derive this potential energy? From you consider system of two charges in the absence of external electric field, where charge Q1, amount of work done to bringing charge Q1 from infinity to at point A. In this case, there is no work done because of there is no electric field due to against the charge Q1. But work done to move the charge Q1 from infinity to at A. In this case, there is no work done because there is no opposite electric field to the charge Q1. But amount of work done to bring charge Q2 from infinity to at that point B, it possesses potential energy because of it work done against the electric field due to charge Q1. Amount of work done to bringing charge Q1 from infinity to at A. In this case, there is no work done because of there is no electric field against the charge Q1. But amount of work done to bring or carry the Q2 charge from infinity to at that point B, in this case, work must be done against the force due to charge Q1. The charge Q2 in the field of Q1, it possesses potential energy. how it possesses potential energy. For when charge Q it produces electric potential at B is given by electric potential due to Q1 at B distance or at B distance or from A is given by V is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 by R. This is the equation 1. How to derive potential energy? Amount of work done to bringing a charge Q2 against the field of Q1. It must be possess some potential energy. How you derive this potential energy? Potential energy is equal to work done to bringing Q2 against the field of Q1, or is equal to potential into charge Q2. Work done is equal to potential due to charge Q1 into charge Q2. Means work done to bringing Q2 against the field of Q1. This work must be done against the force due to Q1, where W is equal to V into Q2. Substitute equation 1 into work done is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R. In this case, work must be done against the electrostatic potential.